You're looking at the first photograph of the Chicago Police Department's two people of interest who were in the area of the alleged assault and battery of Empire star Jussie Smollett. ET's Angelique Jackson is on the story. Thank you so much for joining us, Angelique. Why are the Chicago PD seeking out these two subjects, Angelique?
So earlier today, the Chicago Police Department released these photos of these two people of interest. They have said that while the video, the surveillance video where these photos came from, does not capture an encounter between these individuals and Jussie Smollett, that they are wanting to interview these two people, and they're asking the public's help in figuring out who they were. These images were captured between 1:30 and 1:45 a.m., and they want to interview these people in order to determine whether or not they may have had any involvement in this reported incident.
Well, I'm hoping that eventually some more images might come out or some more footage, because it's really hard to look at that picture and get any idea of who those two people are. But it's comforting to know that they're working hard on the case. Angelique, will Empire resume production tomorrow, and will anything be different?
Well, Lisa, let me answer your first questions first, that more cameras are being reviewed. So it is a good sign that they have found these two individuals, and they are continuing to canvass the area and figure out if there's any more video of these two individuals or anyone else that could potentially have been involved. And then as an answer to your second question, Empire is resuming production tomorrow. They were, of course, canceled because of the extreme weather in Chicago today, but they will be back on set tomorrow. And it kind of remains to be seen exactly what that will look like. But ET has learned that counselors will be on set for the cast indefinitely as they recover from what has gone on in these last couple days. And additionally, there will be armed security on the set as well.
Good.
That is phenomenal, as there should be. Sources also tell ET that Jussie received a threatening letter last week and declined an offer for extra security. The website thatgrapejuice.net says they've obtained that letter, which you see here. That's the actual letter that Jussie received that was threatening. I mean, this is, you can't make this stuff up.
Representative Bobby Rush, he is somebody that is doing something about this. He's putting his money where his mouth is. He represents much of Chicago's South Side and South Suburbs in Congress. He has called on the FBI to investigate this as a hate crime. Angelique, can you tell us a little bit how that will change this whole scenario?
I think that this is an important step. The FBI, of course, being involved makes this even more serious. This is, while the Chicago PD is, of course, doing all they can in this investigation, it just elevates it to an additional level, getting the federal government involved to hopefully use their resources to aid in this investigation, because a hate crime is a very serious offense.
Angelique, it's what I don't understand is why. What we know from this occurrence is that he was called racial slurs and homophobic slurs, correct?
Mm-hmm. That is what he has reported. Yes, that
okay.
Is
yes. Right, and then also that there was other physical involvement with the noose as well. Yes.
Yes. Police, of course, in their release today, they say that when the victim returned to his residence, he reported that he was attacked by these two male subjects. He would report that he was struck several times and that he was knocked to the ground. So in that reporting, yes, that is all very physical.
Right. So if that ain't a hate crime, I don't know what is. And I get so emotional and irritated when people, I mean, I know we have to do our due diligence as journalists to make sure the reporting is right. Mm-hmm. But I mean, if it looks like a duck and quacks like a duck, then damn it, it's a duck.
Yeah.
Point blank,
yeah.
Period. Anyways, I mean, sorry guys, not to go on a tangent. It's just this whole thing.
No, a lot of people are echoing the same thing you're saying on social media. But like you said, when you get into politics and as far as journalists, we kind of have to take the appropriate measures.
Absolutely. We're waiting for the police to tell us exactly what they know. And we kind of have to wait as it unfolds to say what we can and can't confirm directly, or until Jussie himself speaks out
right
to the public.
Yes, ma'am.
True. ET can also confirm that Smollett will perform a scheduled concert this Saturday. I cannot wait, at the Troubadour in West Hollywood.
I'm glad. It makes me very happy to see that, you know, he's not going to let this keep him down.
Of course.
Now, as you said earlier, time and time again, that Jussie's the type of person that takes a negative situation and uses a platform to raise awareness and to send a message that, hey, there's power in numbers and we cannot be stopped. So I'm glad that he's back and he's going to be doing some grateful things. Angelique, thank you so much. Always
thank
a
you,
pleasure.
Angelique.
Of course, and we'll keep you guys updated. I mean, this information keeps coming fast and furious from the police, which is actually a very wonderful thing.
Yes.
Because it shows just how dedicated they are to finding out exactly what happened here and also in keeping the public involved because they know there's so much interest in this case.
So true. Thank you so much, Angelique.